Today in federal court, a doctor who worked at Charity Hospital testified about the actions of two police officers that he called, quote, highly unusual. WDSU News reporter Gina Swanson joins us live with more testimony in the trial of Raymond Robair's death. Gina?
That's right, Scott. We heard from a doctor, Sigilito, who worked on Raymond Robair once the police officers dropped him off at Charity Hospital. He says never in his 12-year career at Charity had he seen police officers bring someone in who was in critical condition or condition that Raymond Robair was in. He said normally if someone is in that condition, officers usually call an ambulance or an emergency medical service. Now, we should also say we heard from the testimony of an NOPD dispatch worker. She testified that the hospital actually contacted NOPD, asking officers Melvin Williams and Matthew D. Moore to return to the hospital because once they started to work on Robair, it was obvious to the hospital workers that he had suffered severe trauma, like he had been severely beaten. They wanted the officers to return because they indicated that it could possibly be a homicide investigation. Now, Raymond Robair was on the 1500 block of Dumaine Street on July 30th, 2005. Neighbors in that area and people who saw the incident say this is a man who was beaten for no reason. Now, community groups who monitor police brutality have long been wanting the Justice Department to get involved, and they are paying very close attention to this case.
We're very pleased that we've seen them prosecuted, and we're hoping for others to come. That's why when the Department of Justice came in, we asked them to probe into other murder cases, since we know the police officers has been known now for misconduct, as shown in the Madison case, the Glover case, and now the Robair case, and there's many other cases, such as my own brother.
Now, we should mention for the defense's part, they tried to insinuate that it could have been a mistake on the part of Charity Hospital that actually led to Robair's death. That's the story for now from federal court. I'm Gina Swanson. Back to you.
All right, Gina, thanks. And coming up at 6, Gina will have more on the testimony of one witness who says he did not want to testify against police officers because of fear of retaliation to his family.